Hello YouTube, and hello to my dear subscribers. Thank you for watching to another one of my videos. And this morning I watched a very interesting video from the Extreme RPG Gamer. And I'll leave the link to his website here down in the comment box, so you can warp to his YouTube channel if you like to investigate his videos as well. I surely recommend you doing that after watching this video. He made a video called 7 Best Battle Systems, or very 7 Interesting Battle Systems. And I enjoyed watching that video, and yeah, he got the idea as well from somebody else. And now I'm taking his idea to make such a video as well. 7 interesting battle systems. And as the Extreme RPG Gamer opened this video, it's just about the games that I played. It's all RPG, of course, but there are so many RPG games that I haven't played. And who has played them all? So it's about games I played and which I remember them for their great battle systems. And I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 as well. Some older, some newer. And yeah, let's start at number 7. And for me at number 7, I have put Ni No Kuni. One thing that made this game so great was the battle system. And of course the world, everything looked marvelous. Level 5 really did such a great job on this game. And the battle system with those small creatures and the bit Pokemon expect, you gotta gather them all or collect them all. And yeah, the weaknesses to fire and ice. And having the battle system, fighting with those creatures was great fun. And yeah, you can switch to use your character or the creature. But basically you'll be fighting with the creatures. And yeah, this battle system I enjoyed very much. So Ni No Kuni, I think, was very well done battle system at number 7. At number 6, it is the second and last PlayStation 3 game. Maybe not many people would put this in a list, but I did. And that's The Guided Fate Paradox from Nippon Ishii Software. The Guided Fate Paradox, it's a roguelike dungeon crawling game. So it's not a dungeon crawler like Aegean Odyssey, but it's roguelike, and roguelike is a bit different. And but Nippon Ishii Software made a great standard for the new generation of roguelike dungeon crawling games. Yeah, they made so much it into more. Playing the old roguelike dungeon crawling games like Izuma or Mystery Dungeon, they were just so basic. Just move one step and then the enemy moves one step, and that's the basic. But the Guided Fate Paradox, you have someone following you, which has been done in other roguelike games as well. But for a small example, you can give her or him orders like stay here or go back, make your distance. Small additions, and yeah, the battle system is fun. This uses a weakness system as well. So if you have enemies who are weak to fire, it's best to use your fire staff. Or if they are weak to stone, use your whatever shoes or other parts of your inventory that are stone based. So yeah, it implemented the weakness system in roguelike games, a good follower. And yeah, it's from the creators of Disgaea, and I like NIS games, so this game made a revolution in roguelike dungeon crawling games. Very adorable battle system. At number 5, I have put, hey, that's Final Fantasy X. Extreme RPG gamer, he made some great arguments for why this game should be in his list, or in, well, the arguments, it made it go in my list as well. The battle system is so great, especially because you can switch out party members. If you are in need of a healer, well, you switch out one melee and get the healer back, or a black mage, or Waka for his ball, so you can attack flyers. And so I'm glad they remastered this game now in HD. So one day I can re-enjoy Final Fantasy X. Yeah, it's still a little bit turn-based battles, but it has the ATB system, of course. So you'll have to make your turn within a specific time, or you'll lose one turn. But I like the idea of using the white mage or a black mage, or the one with the ball, and you can switch them out to whenever you like. So Final Fantasy X is for me at spot number 5. And at number 4, basically a new kid on the block. And for me it was a very welcome battle system. And that is from Bravely Default, the game that just been released a few months ago by Square Enix. And why did Bravely Default make it at number 4 for me? Maybe some other games did this before, like some Final Fantasy game or Four Heroes of Light. I never played those, so I can't say. What made it very attracting battle system in this game is switching the job classes. That's one of the first things I want to mention. 16, 18 job classes to pick from. And you can give every character 2 job classes. So for each boss you can at forehand, of course, decide, okay, I'm gonna try it with a pirate and a monk, or a white mage and a dancer. Dancer was very popular, by the way, for me, for one of my characters. But for each boss you can strategically decide, okay, I'm gonna use these classes. And for grinding, that means as well, you gotta grind a lot to get your characters up in the job level. And the other good part about the battle system of Bravely Default is the brave and default. If you play the game, you know what I mean. Brave and default means if you default, you defend and lose a turn. That's nothing new, but by defaulting one turn, let's say you default one turn, next turn you can do 2 moves or 2 attacks. So it's not basically just defend, but you'll save your move for the next turn, so you can make a double move in the next turn. Or for grinding battles, you could go up to 4 moves. You could also say, okay, I'm gonna do 4 moves in the first turn and then do 3 turns do nothing. But in the grinding battles, if you use 4 turns in the first turn, that's you defeated the enemy, so you can grind much quicker. So the brave and default system plus all the job classes made this game a battle system that I enjoyed very much, and to my opinion more RPG games could use this battle system. And it was turn-based, of course, which I love turn-based. At number 3, a to my opinion, revolutionary game. It's a shame I don't have the original PlayStation game anymore. Those days I wasn't interested in keeping my games, so I sold everything. And what game I also sold was back in those days was I got the PlayStation Portable version, so it's at least I got it somehow. Final Fantasy Tactics, The War of the Lions. I can remember playing it the first time on the old PlayStation 1, and I was truly sold to this game. At that moment, maybe I played Final Fantasy 7 before, maybe not. I think I played Final Fantasy 7, so I was still new in the RPG games, and this game, yeah, blew my mind. Is how to say, Final Fantasy Tactics was so great. Yeah, strategy, job classes, leveling up, grinding, everything was new for me at those days, and it's still the mother of all strategy RPG games. The one who thought up this game or created it deserves some honor. He made a great standard for what tactical RPG games should be. And there are many strategy games released after that, but there are only a few that come close to this one. So Final Fantasy Tactics, I wish I had the Black Label version, is for me number 3. At number 2, it's basically a series that I like very much, and I picked the one that I remember enjoying the most. I'll show it first. It's Tales of the Abyss. I don't have the PlayStation 2 version, basically because Tales of the Abyss has never been released in Europe besides the 3DS version. But I don't think, my opinion is, Tales of the Abyss deserves to be on a PlayStation 2 and not on a small screen on the 3DS. So we never got it in Europe, Tales of the Abyss, my favorite Tales game. As well for the battle system. Tales games, they really know how to improve their battle system with each new game that gets released. Basically, some exceptions. And it's action RPG, and I like the fighting battles of Tales games very much. But if you are used to the current gen, for me it's always a little bit hard to enjoy the older gen, which you remind they were great. For example, now Tales of Symphonia. I played it a little bit on the PlayStation 3, haven't completed it. Got to the second world, by the way. But if you played Graces F and Celia, then it's a different battle system, it's older. And in the days of Symphonia, I tried playing Tales of Phantasia. That's a real, very old Tales game. That's really the first that I played ever. And I tried Phantasia, and that battle system was so slow. And I remember that battle system being great. You have an archer in the back, and he shoots arrows at flying monsters. But if you replay it, it's so slow, battle system. So Tales games know how to upgrade their battle system to the next generation, or how to improve it. But Tales of the Abyss, yeah, the combination of magical glyphs on the ground and then a melee strike on that glyph. That combination of battle system, that part of the battle system I enjoyed very much. And you can stop the battle system and give your party member orders, like do a fireball or heal me. So it's not continuously running, you can pause it and give party members orders. And the characters as well are great in this game, but it's battle system, so Tales Games, and especially Tales of the Abyss, is my number 2. And my number 1, basically it's a series, but for me I took the 2 games out of the series that are for me great ones. And the first one in the series is I took Persona 3. This is FES, but basically I took Persona 3. Why did I do that? It's the start of the new generation of battle system for Persona games. Like we had Persona 3 FES 4 and Persona 3 Portable, 4 Golden. And Persona 3 was the first time they made a change into this battle system of Shin Megami Tensei. The true hardcore Shin Megami fans think that with Persona 3 they went the wrong way, but for me it's great. And the Shin Megami Tensei battle system is for me my favorite battle system. It's turn-based, it costs lots of spells, you got a weakness system. If you explore a weakness on the enemy, you get a free turn. All those kind of things make the Shin Megami Tensei battle system for me most enjoyable. So I enjoyed all the Persona games after Persona 3 I enjoyed, and Persona 3 of course as well. So Persona 3 FES was Persona 3 was the first time they went into this new battle system. Persona 4 was better because you could control all party members. In this game you can control only your protagonist and only give basic orders to others, general orders, but not. So Persona 4 is better, but Persona 3 is the first time they went into the new battle system for Persona games. And what comes with Shin Megami Tensei as well is 2 games I enjoyed very much. The Devil Survivor series. There's also a 3DS version of this Devil Survivor. Devil Survivor, it's a turn-based strategy game which uses the Shin Megami Tensei game. And basically this is the game I enjoyed, of the battle system I enjoyed a little bit more than Persona. I love Persona battle system, but this just a little bit more. It's so much. You have the Shin Megami battle system, the weaknesses, everything. It's got everything and the strategic element. It's not an easy game. Some battles you have to do over a few times, but that's what making this series very interesting, very recommendable as well. If you like strategy games, try that Devil Survivor 1 and 2. I'm sure you're gonna love that as well. So Shin Megami Tensei battle system is for me the one that I enjoy the most. And that's my top 7. I hope you liked the video. As well for my video, if you have some suggestions or you have some games you like the battle system from as well, leave it in the comment box. I love reading them. Sometimes it takes some days before I respond to my videos. Then I'm just hooked up to my PlayStation 3 and addicted to one game. So then I won't check my videos, for which I'm sorry. But I'll try to respond to each one day. Thanks for watching. Enjoy your gaming and we'll see each other next time. Bye bye from Karna.